In its history, this village has been a part of Hungary, Czechoslovakia, and the Soviet Union. Now, as a part of Ukraine, the area still has a sizable ethnic Hungarian population. At this high school, like at many schools in the area, the only courses taught in Ukrainian are literature and the Ukrainian language. This could change in the future. A proposed new law would make Ukrainian the only language to be used in schools, but it's still not completely clear how much primary education would be affected. The language of elementary school education is one that could remain Hungarian. Then, according to the first reading, in 3 years we would gradually have to change to the Ukrainian language in grades 5 to 10. The Ukrainian government is aware of how schools like this one operate, and it is working to ease the minds of residents in the area.
Of course, we do admit, however, that we have to make the textbooks better. We have to make the content better. We have to make it more fit to reality of the 21st century. And we also have to make it fit to the needs of those kids whose native language is not Ukrainian.
Even with these reassurances, some parents are still wary.
The future of my child is what's worrying me, what's going to happen to her in the coming period, because the situation is not easy.
In 2017, to counter Russian propaganda, Ukraine passed a law making the Ukrainian language the sole official language. This caused many minority groups, especially Hungarians, to become concerned, and it inflamed tensions between Ukraine and Hungary, with Budapest even blocking talks between Ukraine and the EU and NATO as a result. Yet, it's still to be seen how and when this new law will be implemented and what effects it will have. The Hungarian government is working to balance the needs of the minorities and the desire for promoting the state's national language.